alaikum, everyone. My name is Huda. I'm just a community member here at MCC. I'm also Palestinian. And I wanted to take a moment to thank MCC for inviting me to speak and for hosting this event. As the daughter, both of us, of Palestinian refugees, it's comforting and so reassuring to know that the community stands with Palestine and that their cries are not falling on deaf ears. I'm going to try to get through this without getting too emotional, inshallah, as best as I can. So I just want to take a moment to tell you a little bit about myself and my experience in Palestine when I was younger, and what life has been like for Palestinians who have family that are still in Gaza and in the West Bank. So as for myself, my father's grandfather was driven out of Jerusalem, and they fled to neighboring Jordan, where my father was raised. And eventually, he came to the United States in the 1970s as a young man. My mother's grandfather and his family were also driven out, but they fled to Gaza, where they still remain today. For them, life in Gaza has always been unbearable, borders being controlled by a brutal military occupation, where the food supply, travel, goods, water, and electricity is intentionally restricted by the occupation. Growing up in cozy California, I never really was aware of the extent of the situation until I myself, as a junior of high school, went to Gaza. This was during the ceasefire, I believe, in 1999. My mother's father was terminally ill, and she wanted us to meet him. And she wanted the opportunity to see him as she came to California as an 19-year-old girl getting married, and she had not returned since. So it had been many years, and she wanted to see him one more time, and she wanted her kids to know him. I remember after an exhausting flight, getting off the plane and being greeted by armed Israeli occupation forces. They wanted to interrogate my mother, who was alone in the airport with her 5 children, as to why she was coming into the country. That was my first experience living the injustices that we had only heard our parents talk about. Even as a young teenager in that moment, being faced with this armed soldier and the way that he was speaking to us, I felt dehumanized, I felt degraded, humiliated, and not having been used to this, I was very angry. And as growing up in American schools and being sold on from a young age the idea of freedom and justice for all, I looked the soldier in his eyes and I told him, I want to speak to your supervisor. What makes you think that you could treat us this way? And he looked at me so condescendingly, laughed as he continued to give us a hard time. My young self, with a strong spirit of fairness and justice, realized in that moment that this place did not play by the rules. This place was different. My time there, however, once we finally reached Gaza, was full of happy memories. I'm sorry. I remember laughing with my cousins as we hung up laundry together on the rooftop of my grandparents' home in Mukhayyam al-Shatit refugee camp. Sharing small meals together as a large family, the excitement of going and getting the popular shaved ice, barad, in the clear plastic cup from the local street vendor. But I also remember the cold showers, the very limited water supply, power outages for parts of the day, destroyed apartment complexes from the previous attacks from the Israeli occupation. And having to send our dishes to the local oven, because there was no oven at the house. Just at the end of the road, they would send their dishes of what they wanted to bake for that night's dinner down the road so that he would bake it for them. Yet, I still remember being so impressed that despite having so little, they were full of joy and iman and contentment. And now, all these years later, to see the horror unfolding on my TV screen, like a movie, unable to help them, unable to be in, to make an immediate difference in their lives. It has me from a distance here has made me physically ill. I can't sleep at night. I can't go to bed. I can't function. I wake up with headaches from thinking constantly. And this is not just me. All Palestinians living abroad who have to watch this feel this way. All we can do is think about them. How are my cousins doing? How are their children? What about the neighbor that gave us sugar when we were out, when I was there in Gaza? What about the baker that we used to send our dishes to? Are they still alive? Are their kids alive? Are they under the rubble? Are their homes demolished? Power has always been limited by the occupation forces. But now it is even worse. And days go by. We don't know what's happening to them. So we watch Al Jazeera Live to get the news coverage directly from the reporters on the ground. And then just a few days ago, a week or so ago, the day that I fear finally came. And I could hear the reporter on Al Jazeera screaming, Mukhayyam al-Shatit, Mukhayyam al-Shatit is being bombarded. Airstrikes, Mukhayyam al-Shatit. Just where I was. And I can't turn it off. I just want to watch the news. I was frozen, glued to the TV, unable to function or do anything else. But scan the bloodied and maimed bodies flooding into the hospital, scanning the faces of people carrying them, wondering if these people could be my cousins whom I haven't seen. Is that my cousin? Is that who they are? Hoping to see that they are okay and alive and praying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not to see them on a stretcher and not having to learn about it this way. Alhamdulillah, my aunt in Denmark was able to make contact with one of my younger cousins on Facebook. And he told her that, alhamdulillah, the members of our family made the harrowing trip from northern Gaza to southern Gaza with extended family, taking what little belongings they could carry with them. And now they're all staying with one family member, all crammed into one small space. No electricity, no water, no heating, no way to cook their meals. We received one photograph because they don't have a way to charge their phones. They must conserve electricity. They can't even send us voice notes. Just a word here, a word there, maybe a picture. We received a picture of gray bricks with some shrubs and cardboard torn up to create a fire. Subhanallah, yet despite this years of occupation, years of living under siege and checkpoints and injustice in their homes, now Western media is trying to silence even us here with lies and AI-generated images. Yet, subhanallah, their constant coverage of Palestine has only done the opposite. It has shown the world the courage, the fortitude, the strength, the resilience, and as one TikTok user put it, the ironclad faith. The ironclad faith of the people in the Holy Land. Subhanallah. This wall-to-wall coverage, there are millions of dollars that they're spending on their smear campaigns and lies against the people of the Holy Land has only made the world curious to ask, what is Islam? What is this unusual faith where a man could be carrying the bloodied bodies of his children and only say joyously, Alhamdulillah, with pure and full contentment? There's one thing they don't know about Gazawiya and our brothers and sisters in Al-Daffa and the West Bank is how extraordinarily strong their iman is, how content they are with Allah's plan, and how tightly they hold on to the Allah's rope. How I've learned that they are just cut from a different cloth, excelling with sabrun jameen, a beautiful patience and resilience, and teaching the world what it means to say La ilaha illallah subhanahu wa ta'ala. La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. And they bow to no one but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And despite not having even the simple comforts, the lights, the water, electricity, still every day, every time we get a voice note, a message from them, always, Alhamdulillah. Every night, Alhamdulillah. Praying in masajids that have been struck by shrapnel, destroyed, they still go to the masjid every salah, Alhamdulillah. My 22-year-old cousin, Mahmoud, is a shaheed, hafiz of Quran, teacher of Quran. And all my uncle says is Alhamdulillah. He doesn't even want me to say to him, Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. They say, Azzam Allahu ajrakum. They have submitted themselves fully and completely and their families to Allah's will. They know their purpose. They know Amr al-Mu'min Ajib. They have their eye on the eternal prize of Al-Jannah. But do we truly remember Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un and live and support them fearlessly? Their strength and resilience does not absolve us from our obligations here to act and speak. As you know, the occupation's digital forces has seen the impact of the news coming directly out of Palestine and how it has shifted the public opinion. And they're doing everything in their power with secret meetings, with social media executives that they have access to silence journalists coming out of Gaza and activists who repost their content. Just a few days ago, a page called Eye on Palestine that reports directly from Gaza, 6 million followers, was taken down without any kind of notice. Images and videos from Gaza are being taken down. Accounts are being blocked. Journalists are being censored. They want to ethnically cleanse and commit genocide under the veil of darkness. Particularly in these last 2 days, as we were just discussing, there's their internet. They're not able to get it out. Even the journalists are having trouble with connectivity. So this is where we can step in, inshallah. We as Muslims here who have full electricity, unlimited, can use our resources to amplify their voices, that we can stand with haq fearlessly and use our platforms, our voices, our du'as and our night prayers like this to support them. So that when we stand before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we too can stand with a clear conscience and a pure heart and say that we truly did everything we can to support our brothers and sisters in Palestine. Jazakum Allah khair. Assalamu alaikum.
So, as sister said, at least I know our brothers and sisters in Gaza, I don't know if they're sleeping now or not even sleep. So we should not be sleeping the whole night. We should fear them, we should be with them, we should at least say, Hasbunallah wa ni'mal wakeel. Allah, inshallah. Inshallah, Allah will bring the victory, inshallah. So let's do this dua, inshallah, with the intention, with the niyyah of al-faraj, inshallah, with intention of ease and al-nasr and victory, inshallah. It's just dua, inshallah, people they used to read before us, inshallah. Let's read it in the same intention, inshallah. Bismillah. يا من إلى رحمته المفر ومن إليه يلجأ المضطر ويا قريب العفو يا مولاه ويا مغيث كل من دعاه بك استغاثنا يا مغيث الضعفاء فاحسبنا يا رب أنت وكفى فلا أجل من عظيم قدرتك ولا أعز من عزيز سطوتك لعز ملكك الملوك تخضع تخفض قدر من تشاء وترفع والأمر كله إليك رده وبيديك حله وعقده وقد رفعنا أمرنا إليك وقد شكونا ضعفنا عليك فارحمنا يا من لا يزال عليما بضعفنا ولا يزال رحيما
انظر إلى ما مسنا من الورى فحالنا من بينهم كما ترى قد عل جمعنا وقل وفرنا وانحطم بين الجموع قدرنا واستضعفونا شوكة وشدة واستنقصونا عدة وعدة فنحن يا من ملكه لا يسلب لذنا بجاهك الذي لا يغلب إليك يا غوث الفقير نستند عليك يا كف الضعيف نعتمد أنت الذي ندعو لكشف الغمرات أنت الذي نرجو لدفع الحصارات أنت العناية التي لا نرتجي حماية من غير بابها تجي أنت الذي نسعى بباب فضله أكرم من أغنى بفيض ليله أنت الذي تهدي إذا ضللنا أنت الذي تفو إذا زللنا وسعت كل ما خلقت علما ورأفة ورحمة وحلما وليس منا في الوجود أحقر ولا لما عندك منا أفقر يا واسع الإحسان يا من خيره عم الورى ولا ينادى غيره يا منقذ الغرق ويا حنان يا منجي الهلك ويا منان ضاق النطاق يا سميع يا مجيب عز الدواء يا سريع يا قريب وقد مددنا ربنا الأكفى ومنك ربنا رجعنا اللطفى وقد مددنا ربنا الأكفى ومنك ربنا رجعنا اللطفى فالطف بنا فيما به قضيت وردنا بما به رضيت وأبدل اللهم حال العسر باليسر وامددنا بريح النصر وأبدل اللهم حال العسر باليسر وامددنا بريح النصر واجعل لنا على البغاة الغلبة واقصر أذى الشر على من طلبه واقهر عدانا يا عزيز قهرا يفصم حبلهم ويصم الظهرا واعكس مرادهم وخيب سعيهم واهزم جيوشهم وأفسد رأيهم وعجل اللهم فيهم نقمتك فإنهم لا يعجزون قدرتك وعجل اللهم فيهم نقمتك فإنهم لا يعجزون قدرتك يا ربي يا ربي بحبل عصمتك قد اعتصمنا وبعز نصرتك فكن لنا ولا تكن علينا ولا تكلنا طرفة إلينا فما أطاقنا قوة للدافع ولا استطعنا حيلة للنفع
وما قصدنا
ربابك الكريم وما رجونا غير فضلك العميم فما رجعت من خيرك الظنون بنفس ما تقول كن يكون يا ربي يا ربي بك التوصل لما لديك وبك التوسل يا ربي أنت ركننا الرفيع يا ربي أنت حصننا المنيع يا ربي يا ربي أنلنا الأمنا إذا ارتحلنا وإذا أقمنا يا ربي واحفظ زرعنا وضرعنا واحفظ تجارنا ووفر جمعنا واجعل بلادنا بلاد الدين وراحة المحتاج والمسكين واجعل لها بين البلاد صولة وحرمة ومنعة ودولة واجعل من السر المصون عزها واجعل من الستر الجميل حرزها، واجعل بصاد وبقاف وبنون ألف حجاب من ورائها يكون، بجاه نور وجهك الكريم وجاه سر ملكك العظيم، وجاه لا إله إلا الله وجاه خير الخلق يا رباه، وجاه ما به دعاك الأنبياء، وجاه ما به دعاك الأولياء، وجاه قادر القطب والأوتاد، وجاه حال والأفراد، وجاه الأخيار وجاه النجباء، وجاه الأبدال وجاه النقباء، وجاه كل عبد وذاكر، وجاه كل حميد وشاكر، وجاه كل من رفعت قدره ممن سترت أو نشرت ذكره، وجاه آيات الكتاب المحكم، وجاه الاسم الأعظم المعظم. يا ربي يا ربي وقفنا فقراء بين يديك ضعفاء حقراء، وقد دعوناك دعاء من دعا ربا كريما لا يرد من سعى، فاقبل دعاءنا بمحض الفضل قبل من ألغى حساب العدل، ومن علينا منة الكريم واطف علينا عطفة الحليم، وانشر علينا يا رحيم رحمتك، وابسط علينا يا كريم نعمتك، وخير في سائر الأقوال، واختر لنا في سائر الأفعال، يا ربي واجعل دأبنا التمسك بالسنة الغراء والتنسك، واحصر لنا أغراضنا المختلفة فيك، وعرفنا تمام المعرفة، واجمع لنا ما بين علم وعمل، واصرف إلى دار البقاء منا الأمل، وانهج بنا يا ربي نهج السعداء، واختم لنا يا ربي خاتم الشهداء، واجعل بنينا فضلاء صلحاء، وعلماء عاملين نصحاء، وأصلح اللهم حال الأهل، ويسر اللهم جمع الشمل، يا ربي وافتح فتحك المبينة لمن تولى وأعز الدين، وانصره يا ذا الطول وانصر حزبه، واملأ بما يرضيك عنه قلبه، يا ربي وانصر ديننا المحمدي، واجعل ختام عزه كما بدي، واحفظه يا ربي بحفظ العلماء، وارفع منار نوره إلى السماء، واعفي وعافي واكفي واغفر ذنبنا وذنب كل مسلمين يا ربنا، وصلي يا ربي على المختار صلاتك الكاملة المقدار، صلاتك التي تفي بأمره كما يليق بارتفاع قدره، ثم على الآل الكرام وعلى أصحابه الغر ومن تمتلى، والحمد لله الذي بحمده يبلغ ذو القصد تمام قصده. الفاتحة على نية القبول إن شاء الله. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين، آمين. حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل، 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 حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل. ربنا أفرغ علينا صبرا وثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. ربنا أفرغ علينا صبرا وثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. ربنا أفرغ علينا صبرا وثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. نستغيث بك يا الله، نستغيث بك يا الله، نحن الفقراء، نحن الضعفاء، وأنت القوي المقتدر. اللهم عليك بالظالمين، اللهم عليك بالمعتدين، اللهم عليك بهم فإنهم لا يعجزونك يا رب العالمين. أحصهم عددا واقتلهم بددا، ولا تبقى ولا تغادر منهم أحدا يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من إرهاب المرهبين ومن سفك دماء الآمنين، وأن على التعدي على أحد من خلقك أجمعين. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك يا أرحم الراحمين على التعدي على أحد من خلقك أجمعين. اللهم إنهم يا أرحم الراحمين يغتروا يا أرحم الراحمين بقوتهم، ولا حولنا ولا حول لنا ولا قوة إلا بك. فاللهم انصرنا عليهم، اللهم انزل ملائكة من السماء لإخواننا في فلسطين تدافع عنهم يا الله. لا حول لهم ولا قوة إلا بك يا الله، إنهم صابرون، إنهم صابرون. اللهم يا أرحم الراحمين انصرهم نصرا عزيزا تعز به الدين وتدل به راية الشرك والمشركين. اللهم حرر المسجد الأقصى ورده إلى أيدي المسلمين عاجلا غير آجلا يا رب العالمين. آمين آمين، والحمد لله رب العالمين.